is stirring up the church back to the reminder. It's time to get our hearts right before God individually. We can talk about a nation as a whole again, but to get our hearts right. The Bible talks about a washing of regeneration by the renewing of the Word of God, by the working of the Holy Spirit. Paul talks about it in Romans 12, by the renewing of your mind that you might be able to prove what is the perfect and acceptable will of God concerning you. And so what God is saying is there's things in our soulish man that needs to be perfected. And we need the Word of God to perfect us. But if we're not in the Word of God, and if we are not seeking Christ through His Word, and we are caught up in everything that's going on around us, and just spend just a portion of time, how can we find that place of where God wants us to be? We keep asking God for more of Him, and He keeps saying, you got to have less of you to get more of me. He said, unless you decrease, I cannot increase. That's the problem. We're looking for this hocus pocus by focus God to fill us so we can buck and jerk in our churches, and people on the street are dying, going to hell, and nobody's got the guts to go out there and preach the gospel because they don't have the Holy Spirit to empower them to go. But guess what? God's going to put us all in the street. We're all going to be in the street. And the people that we're running away from, the people that have toxic thinking down there on the ghetto streets, that you're going to be right next to them. He's going to make us all come together. And the thing that's going to make us support, to cut us the difference between another, they're going to see something of quality in us that ain't nobody else has. And man didn't give it to me, and man can't take it away. They're going to say, what is the hope that's in him? And James says that we ought to be able to give an account for everyone that asks for the hope that lies within us. He says, I want to stir up your pure minds by the way of reminder, that you may be mindful of the words which were spoken before by the holy prophets. See, we don't need a bunch of prophets running around telling us what God is saying. Listen what he said there. He said, I'm going to tell you what the holy prophets already prophesied about. We don't need someone to come tell us. That's why he sent the Holy Spirit. He said, when the Spirit of truth comes, he will show you all things of me. He won't speak of himself, but he'll speak of me. We keep looking to men to hear what God is saying. We can hear what God is saying through men to confirm.